Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the August 28th meeting of the Delhi Township Board of Trustees. We will begin tonight with the Pledge of Allegiance, followed by a moment of silence. Our moment of silence tonight is dedicated to Mr. Michael Kappa. And Mr. Kappa was the father of seven, the grandfather of 20, and the great-grandfather of 20. But he was most known for his service to his community as well as his family. 31 years with the Cincinnati Fire Department, and he was also president of the retired firefighters organization. He spent 54 years at Christ Hospital, both as an employee and as a volunteer. And in this area, for 45 years, he also volunteered with the Boy Scouts. There's so many of us in Delhi who have been the recipient of Mr. Kappa's great works that we wish him the very best to rest in peace. Thank you, Mr. Kappa.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. All right, everyone, I think it's rather poetic that tonight we also, besides Mr. Kappa being 45 years with the Boy Scouts, we have a guest with us. That's Alex Brigger, and Alex is with Troop 909 from St. Dominic's, and he's working on his communications badge. So maybe sometime you met one of the Kappas volunteering with the Boy Scouts, but they have a long history of dedication to that group. So thank you for being here, and best of luck on getting your badge. All right, then. Mr. Luby, do we have an approval of the minutes?
Motion to approve the minutes from the Board of Trustees meeting held on August 14th, 2019, and dispense with the reading.
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor?
Yes.
Yes. Motion approved.
Motion to approve bills for payment.
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor?
Yes.
Yes.
Motion to approve the payment of overtime for pay period ending August 13th, 2019.
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor?
Yes.
Yes. Motion approved. All right, then. Report from the fiscal officer, Mr. Luby.
Resolution 2019-133, resolution approving purchase order obligations incurred on behalf of the township by the township administrator, authorizing payment of certain purchase order obligations and dispensing with a second reading.
I will introduce and move the adoption of this resolution.
I second the adoption of this resolution.
Any discussion on this resolution?
I second the motion to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
I second the motion to dispense the second reading of the resolution.
Can I third it?
Only if you want to.
All those in favor of the motion to dispense with the second reading of this resolution?
Yes.
Yes. Mr. Luby, please call the roll.
Mrs. Seavey?
Yes.
Mr. Davis?
Yeah.
Mrs. Sturts?
Yes.
Resolution passes?
Barely.
Resolution 2019-134, resolution amending appropriations for expenses, declaring emergency, and dispensing with the second reading.
I introduce and move the adoption of this resolution.
I second the adoption of this resolution.
Any discussion on this resolution? Mr. Cameron, do you have some facts to share with us?
Sure. Third could have been one of those words we could have used for tonight.
We could have.
So this supplemental is to add some funds to the law director fees. We budgeted based on an average year, and we've had three issues that were not expected with the loss of our data through the Securus PAMET issue and the PD, working through the purchase of the Remke property, and then the Bearcat appeal. So those are three things we didn't anticipate, and we're having to put some more funds into those, to the law director fee. I will say that we are getting all the law director fees and more the costs we had with the loss of our data. So it's in the $26,000 range, so we will recover that. But in the meantime, we still have to pay the invoices, don't we, Brian? Okay.
I move to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
I second the motion to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
All those in favor of the motion to dispense with the second reading?
Yes.
Mr. Looby, please call the roll.
Mrs. Seavey?
Yes.
Mr. Davis?
Yes.
Mrs. Sturts?
Yes.
Resolution passes.
As far as significant transactions since the last meeting, on A20, we received a deposit for $38,000 from the local government fund, the gasoline tax, and a motor vehicle license tax. On A26, we received $51,000 for the cable franchise fee. On A22, we received $992,000 for real estate tax advance. And as far as disbursements, our payroll on A22 was $282,000. That's all I have.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Looby. Trustees' correspondence. Trustee Davis?
Just a few. First of all, Mount Arverno is open again, which is very nice. Got to take that on the way over. And I don't know how many of you have driven up Delhi Pike lately, but you see a couple of the homes that are coming down, some of those blighted properties down as you enter Delhi from Lower Delhi. And it's awesome. It is awesome to see it, awesome to see them coming down. And Greg, you and the entire department, everybody who has just been so proactive in that with nuisance abatements, properties, everything, trying to just keep Delhi as beautiful, I think, as it is. And it's not easy, I know, with you guys because we have so many of these every meeting, but we don't mind it, honestly. And it's not because Delhi's falling apart. It's because, no, we're actually being proactive, going out and making sure people cut their grass and have their place looking nice to keep the property values nice and high, which is always good. So you come up and through Delhi like that, it's just nice seeing some of those properties coming down that are just shacks is really what they were, and abandoned, and so great things. And then, of course, you see the construction going on with Chase Bank on the Pike, and the liquor store in Delhi that's now expanding behind there. It's a lot of energy happening right now, so it's a good energy. So thank you everybody, because who benefits the most are the residents, and obviously they deserve the best. So thank you.
Thanks, Mike. Trustee Sturts.
Well, I'm sorry, but Trustee Davis stole my thunder. Thanks, Mike. But no, same thing. I mean, there's so much going on in the development, and well, we'll be having the ribbon cutting at our next meeting for Greenside Estates. Thank you. And so they made their announcement and all the homes that are going to go in there. So it is good to see, and that's what we've been doing, is laying the foundation to get all this done. And Greg, you're a huge, huge part of that. So thank you very much.
All right. I'd like to thank everyone who came out to see Shakespeare in the Park. It was a delightful evening, and it had a great crowd, and it was something we've never ventured into. And I think, Mr. Torbeck, I think maybe they'd like to come back.
It was great.
It was really very well done. Also, we just recently went through another storm event, and I want to compliment our public works and our fire department and our police department for quick response to wires down, water coming down a hillside. And you know, when you see these things, just please call, unless it's, you know, life-threatening, call the 922-0060 number and report what you see. The quicker we can get to it, the quicker we can eliminate the problem. But you did a great job, because it all happened quick and fast. So thank you very much. All right, then, back to the agenda. Police Department, I have nothing for you this evening. Is that correct?
Correct.
All right, thank you. But Mr. Ripperger, we do have you. Public Works. Resolution, Mr. Looby?
Resolution 2019-135, resolution certifying to the county auditor final unpaid assessment amounts against abutting property owners for the construction, repair, and maintenance of sidewalk and driveway apron improvements along various township streets ordered in accordance with revised code 5543.10 and its policy and procedures, and dispensing with a second reading.
I introduce and move the adoption of this resolution.
I second the adoption of this resolution.
Any discussion on this resolution, Mr. Ripperger?
Thank you, trustees. This is from the 2018 contract. It's for the aprons and sidewalks that we assessed that year. I think the original contract amount for that was about $47,000, and we're sending about $16,000 down to get assessed. So a good amount of people have already paid, and a lot of positive feedback. And I know it helps the aesthetics of the subdivision pretty much when we're done. Looks good.
It does.
All right. Thank you. Any other questions?
I do have a couple little updates on some county roads.
Okay.
It is good news. Mount Arverno is open right now. but in a couple of weeks it might not be again.
Right. Yeah.
They're not finished, from what I know, and they don't have an exact date of when that'll be closed again, but I think they're going to go over to Anderson Ferry, do some work there, and then go back to Mount Alverno.
I think they still have to pave it and everything, but
yes,
at least it's, yeah,
they haven't even came out and said it was open yet, but I think they're just letting people go through. So that's all I got.
All right, thank you.
Thanks.
Before Mr. Riffinger sits down, one thing that they did last week, Don Lane, there was some issues or concerns with water, with a lot of the rain, and it's a cul-de-sac. So Ron reached out to the county. The county, we went back and forth and devised what would help alleviate some of that. So they installed a catch basin last week. But the point of bringing that up is we do take action if action is available and warranted. And the county came back and helped us and designed, here's what we think can help alleviate if the water gets to that point again. So thank him for doing that. And they do go out and they are trying to be proactive if they can. In that case, it was a little after the fact, but they did the work themselves, and the county was helpful in the process too, which is good.
And that's one of the things that an entire department is promoting, is partnering with the county to get a lot of these things done more efficiently, more effectively. So that's great. Thanks, Ron.
And sometimes we have combined systems
with the county in some of our subdivisions. We've been working with them over the years to solve problems, repair problems, what have you.
All right.
Move to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
I second the motion to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
All those in favor of the motion to dispense with the second reading?
Yes.
Yes. Mr. Luby, please call the roll.
Mrs. Seavey?
Yes.
Mr. Davis?
Yes.
Mrs. Sturts?
Yes.
Resolution passes.
Motion to accept the seasonal resignation of Brandon J. Marchetti in the Public Works Department, effective August 15th, 2019.
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor?
Yes.
Yes. Motion approved. Okay, Fire Department Chief Campbell, you're on. Mr. Luby.
Motion to accept the voluntary resignation of part-time firefighter EMT Michael P. Orlando, effective August 17th, 2019.
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor?
Yes.
Yes.
Is he going somewhere?
Motion approved.
Chief Campbell, where's he going?
No, anywhere? He has just resigned from Delhi.
Oh, okay.
Motion to accept the voluntary resignation of full-time firefighter paramedic Christopher Gundrum, effective August 31st, 2019.
So moved.
With regret, I second it.
Mm. All those in favor?
Yes.
Yes. Motion approved.
And Chief Campbell, he's going to Harrison.
Yeah, it's never easy to lose a full-time firefighter. Chris has been with us for 6 years, 2 years full-time. Really kind of taken a shock to the department, but he is exploring his opportunities with the City of Harrison Fire Department. So we wish him well there.
We do. Blessing.
Motion to approve the hiring of Alec E. McCoy as career firefighter paramedic in the Fire Department at the rate per the collective bargaining agreement with the Local 3389 IAFF, effective September 1st, 2019.
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor?
Yes.
Yes. Motion approved.
Motion to approve the hiring of Hayden C. Dreschler as part-time firefighter EMT in the Fire Department at the rate per the collective bargaining agreement with the Delhi Firefighters Association and successful completion of the pre-employment physical, drug testing, and background check effective on August 29th, 2019.
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor?
Yes.
Yes. Motion approved. Thank you, Chief. You have something for us?
Yes. If the board, I'd like to kind of update you on where we're at personnel-wise. So hiring Alec is facilitated by having the full-time testing processes, and we maintain lists of reasonable candidates. Alec does work for us part-time currently, so it's an easy transition then to bring him in under a full-time capacity. So that's how we're able to quickly turn around the situation from Chris resigning and then hiring Alec. So I hope to present him to the board here at a later date for swearing in. Also with Hayden, I think this is a sign of the times with where the fire service and us recruiting has become increasingly difficult. He is the first application I've received in 7 months. By way of Cleveland, he happened to be moving into the area, submitted a handful of applications to departments that he looked up and tested with us, did very well, and we're kind of excited to bring him in as he comes to the Cincinnati area. But, I mean, ideally that I've never experienced this much of a drought in terms of part-time service, part-time inquiry. So things are tough on the part-time side of, you know, but if anything, you know, Delhi will endure this drought and we'll continue to go out and find the best candidates for our township community.
Well, I'd like to share with you the fact that you recently made a run over on Glen Oaks Drive. And the person that you made the run to called me and could not have been more supportive, more complimentary, and so put at ease by Mr. Morrow. And I just think that's a tremendous feedback when you have someone that's in that, you know, that tragic, sensitive position of needing to call the squad, and yet when they're back home, they call me and say, wow. I mean, they are fantastic. They did a great job, and particularly singled out Morrow.
Very good, very good. That's a.
Please give him our best.
I will. I'm always happy to hear that and share the news with them as well. I mean, I don't withhold it in any capacity. If somebody takes the time to write, call, say something out on the street, you know, regarding one of our paramedics or firefighters, I'm happy to share it with them because that's really what we want to endorse in this community.
Thank you, Chief.
Thank you.
All right, Parks and Recreation, Mr. Luby.
Motion to accept the seasonal resignation of Sherry L. Hawkins in the Parks and Recreation Department, effective July 29th, 2019.
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor?
Yes.
Motion approved.
Board, can
Mr.
I steal
Torbeck.
A minutes of your time? I got a couple things coming up. I just wanted to make a quick announcement. The Delhi Farmers Market this weekend is the last weekend for it, so Saturday from 9 to 12. The summer's almost gone, the final chapter of the Bricka family. That's being moved to the Senior Center because they expect a big crowd. So if you plan on going, it's moved from the Lodge to the Senior Center. September 13th is Excalibur. It's a Friday night concert in the park. We expect a big crowd for that, too. That starts at 7. And then September 20th is Clue and Cocktails. It's a murder mystery night out, kind of themed after the popular game. That is almost full, so you have to register for that. We have about 10 spots left. So if you're interested, call the Parks Department, 451-3300.
Thank you.
That's it. Thank you.
Good things happening.
All right, then. Administration resolution, Mr. Luby.
Resolution 2019-136, resolution authorizing and entering into an administrative services agreement for medical plan administration with Key Benefits Administrators, Inc., KBA, for the purpose of establishing the terms and conditions under which KBA agrees to provide administrative services in connection with the provision certain self-insured group health benefits for eligible township employees and officers, authorizing the township administrator to execute and deliver all necessary documents, declaring an emergency, and dispensing with a second reading.
I introduce and move the adoption of this resolution.
I second the adoption of this resolution.
Any discussion on this resolution? Mr. Cameron?
I can talk on this one and the next several. So we are
one
renewing.
One at a time, or you're going to condense this?
However you would like it.
Condense.
Thank you. These are part and parcel to our renewing of our health insurance benefits, which is October 1st. So we put these in place the month prior so people can sign up and they know it's effective. Being self-insured, we see several pieces. This first one is the third-party administrator and then the plan that we use. The next one is the stop-loss that rides on top of our program, which you put in place. The third one, our health, I'll save that for last. Avisis is our vision insurance that we have as an option. Mm-hmm. Dental insurance, we did a 2-year last year, so we're into our second year. You don't see that one this year. Our health is a new option this year. It is a health clinic that has come to the Cincinnati market. They have 3 locations. They're going to have a third on Harrison Avenue. It's something that we have been looking at for a little while, meaning a little over a year, as a viable option to offer to our covered employees. It's a per employee cost per month, and based on what that cost is, what our claims history is, we expect to save money on versus what we pay in. We are also going to be able to use that for our annual physicals for police, fire, ODOT physicals, and so we're happy about that option because we really like the product. So that's your third resolution, but these next four all are part of our health insurance benefits that renew October 1st.
Okay, thank you for condensing.
You're welcome. I can talk more if you'd like.
Okay. Got this.
I move to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
I second the motion to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
All those in favor of the motion to dispense with the second reading?
Yes.
Yes. Mr. Luby, please call the roll.
Mrs. Seavey?
Yes.
Mr. Davis?
Yes.
Mrs. Sturts?
Yes.
Resolution passes.
Resolution 2019-137, resolution authorizing and entering into the contract providing excess loss insurance with Gerber Life Insurance Company in connection with provision of group health insurance benefits through an individual self-insurance program for the provision of individual and aggregate stop-loss protection, authorizing the township administrator to execute and deliver the necessary documents, declaring an emergency, and dispensing with the second reading.
I introduce and move the adoption of this resolution.
I second the adoption of this resolution.
Any discussion on this resolution?
Move to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
I second the motion to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
All those in favor of the motion to dispense with the second reading?
Yes.
Yes. Mr. Luby, please call the roll.
Mrs. Seavey?
Yes.
Mr. Davis?
Yes.
Mrs. Sturts?
Yes.
Resolution passes.
Resolution 2019-138, resolution entering into the participating employer agreement with Our Health LLC, Our Health, for certain preventive primary and wellness care services at the network of Our Health My Clinics, authorizing the township administrator to execute and deliver the necessary documents, declaring an emergency, and dispensing with the second reading.
I will introduce and move the adoption of this resolution.
I second the adoption of this resolution.
Any discussion on this resolution?
I move to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
I second the motion to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
All those in favor of the motion to dispense with the second reading?
Yes.
Yes. Mr. Luby, please call the roll.
Mrs. Seavey?
Yes.
Mr. Davis?
Yes.
Mrs. Sturts?
Yes.
Resolution passes.
Resolution 2019-139, resolution authorizing and entering into a renewal agreement with the Visus Vision Care Plus for group vision insurance benefits for eligible township employees and officers, authorizing the township administrator to execute and deliver the necessary documents, declaring an emergency, and dispensing with a second reading.
I introduce and move the adoption of this resolution.
I second the adoption of this resolution.
Any discussion on this resolution?
Move to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
I second the motion to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
All those in favor of the motion to dispense with the second reading?
Yes.
Yes. Mr. Luby, please call the roll.
Mrs. Seavey?
Yes.
Mr. Davis?
Yes.
Mrs. Sturts?
Yes.
Resolution passes.
We have a motion to approve the Employee Health Insurance Incentive Program for plan year October 2019 through September 2020, a 1% reduction on employee premium contributions for annual physical and biometric screening for themselves and covered spouse, and a 1% reduction on employee premium contribution for successful participation in the wellness program.
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor?
Yes.
Motion approved. Trustee Sturts, I think you're going to speak for all of us on this.
Yes, I do. I want to thank Mrs. Hermes and Mr. Cameron for all the work that went into all that we just approved. The hours that they had to research and meet with different companies, do cost comparisons, across the board, everything. You just can't imagine the amount of time they ate, breathed, and slept this. Maybe not slept. With saying that, if we had stayed with what we had this year, it would have been over an 80% increase. And so that drove this, but they were able to keep it to about, what did you say, 11%, was it?
No, it's 16%.
16%, okay, sorry, on that number. So it's a savings to our budget, it's a savings to our employees, therefore it's a savings from the budget to all of you out there and our taxpayers. So, they're continually championing for our employees. It helps to maintain good employees to be able to offer these benefits to all of them. And so they also held employee meetings to explain it.
whenever you make a change in your benefits, it's always difficult to understand what's going on, with, as you can see, with all these moving parts. I believe the employees accepted it well. It was clear and concise. And so, again, from my perspective and our board, I want to thank you for all the work that you put into it and to help us all out.
Yes. Well, I will. You're welcome. Thank you for that. And I will pass that along to Mrs. Hermes. Not to overcomplicate it, but when we look at the total spend we expect for this coming year at a maximum level and compare it to this year's spend, we're actually going to spend 4% less. It's the way the premiums set up with the way we did it this past year and the way we're doing it. But the employees have been very good at participating, following along, and we had pretty good attendance. We did open enrollment the last 3 days because of the change. We wanted to do it sooner than later and give everybody a chance to digest what the change is. But I didn't keep a tally sheet, but I think we had the majority of employees that are covered show up, and several spouses were here, which is good because then they can ask questions and not rely on their spouse to not tell them the information, maybe.
Yeah.
But, yeah, no, thank you, and you're welcome.
Right. Anything, Mr. Trustee Davis?
No.
All right.
I think it says it all.
Now, ditto. Thank you from us. I mean, it's it's an important piece of the puzzle of maintaining employees, and we thank you for keeping it right. Thank you. All right, then. Community development, Mr. DeLong. And Mr. Luby, resolution, please.
Resolution 2019-140, resolution certifying violation abatement expenses at 4497 Clover Hill Terrace to the county auditor for assessment, declaring an emergency, and dispensing with a second reading.
I will introduce and move the adoption of this resolution.
I second the adoption of this resolution.
Any discussion on this resolution, Mr. DeLong?
As you can see on the screen, there are before and after photos. This will be a $572 assessment placed on the property.
Okay.
Move to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
I second the motion to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
All those in favor of the motion to dispense with the second reading?
Yes.
Yes. Mr. Luby, please call the roll.
Mrs. Seavey?
Yes.
Mr. Davis?
Yes.
Mrs. Sturts?
Yes.
Resolution passes.
Resolution 2019-141, resolution certifying violation abatement expenses at 688 Libby Joe Drive to the county auditor for assessment, declaring an emergency, and dispensing with a second reading.
I introduce and move the adoption of this resolution.
I second the adoption of this resolution.
Any discussion on this resolution?
Again, you can see the before and after photos up on the screen. This was for excessive vegetation. It was a $520 assessment, which will be placed on their taxes.
Okay.
I move to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
I second the motion to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
All those in favor of the motion to dispense with the second reading?
Yes.
Yes. Mr. Luby, please call the roll.
Mrs. Seavey?
Yes.
Mr. Davis?
Yes.
Mrs. Sturts?
Yes.
Resolution passes.
Resolution 2019-142, resolution declaring nuisance for excessive vegetation at 945 Beach Meadow Lane, declaring an emergency and dispensing with a second reading.
I introduce and move the adoption of this resolution.
I second the adoption of this resolution.
Discussion on this resolution?
Yeah, this property at 945 Beach Meadow, the excessive vegetation is taller than me, unfortunately. It is in the side and rear yards. It was in that condition as of this morning. We do request you declare it a nuisance.
Move to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
I second the motion to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
All those in favor of the motion to dispense with the second reading?
Yes. Yes.
Mr. Luby, please call the roll.
Mrs. Seavey?
Yes.
Mr. Davis?
Yes.
Mrs. Sturts?
Yes.
Resolution passes.
Resolution 2019-143, resolution declaring nuisance for excessive vegetation at 4498 St. Dominic Drive, declaring an emergency and dispensing with a second reading.
I introduce and move the adoption of this resolution.
I second the motion to it. No, I second the adoption of this resolution.
Any discussion on this resolution?
Yeah, unfortunately, this is a house that is at the gateway to St. Dominic Drive off of Pedretti. This is a repeat offender this year, again, for excessive vegetation. We do request you declare it a nuisance.
When I read these, there was more than one repeat violator.
We got a few in here.
Yeah, okay.
Mm-hmm. Move to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
I second the motion to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
All those in favor of the motion to dispense with the second reading?
Yes.
Yes. Mr. Luby, please call the roll.
Mrs. Seavey?
Yes.
Mr. Davis?
Yes.
Mrs. Sturts?
Yes.
Resolution passes.
Resolution 2019-144, resolution declaring nuisance for excessive vegetation at 5321 Plum Ridge Drive, declaring an emergency and dispensing with the second reading.
I introduce and move the adoption of this resolution.
I second the adoption of this resolution.
Any discussion on this resolution?
This is another repeat offender. This property, they did make an attempt. They mowed the front yard, but they neglected to address the backyard. So we do request you declare it a nuisance.
Move to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
I second the motion to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
All those in favor of the motion to dispense with the second reading?
Yes.
Yes. Mr. Luby, please call the roll.
Mrs. Seavey?
Yes.
Mr. Davis?
Yes.
Mrs. Sturts?
Yes.
Resolution passes.
Resolution 2019-145, resolution declaring nuisance for accumulated debris at 5180 Locust Avenue, declaring an emergency and dispensing with a second reading.
I will introduce and move the adoption of this resolution.
I second the adoption of this resolution.
Any discussion on this resolution?
Yeah, this is another repeat offender, and those items were, as you see in the photos, as of this morning. We do request you declare it a nuisance.
I move to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
I second the motion to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
All those in favor of the motion to dispense with the second reading? Yes.
Yes.
Mr. Luby, please call the roll.
Mrs. Seavey?
Yes.
Mr. Davis?
Yes.
Mrs. Sturts?
Yes.
Resolution passes.
Resolution 2019-146, resolution declaring nuisance for accumulated debris at 5374 Cleander Drive, declaring an emergency and dispensing the second reading.
I introduce and move the adoption of this resolution.
I second the adoption of this resolution.
Any discussion on this resolution, Mr. DeLong?
Yeah, this is another repeat offender. We actually abated this property earlier this year. As much as I love Santa Claus, there is a lot of debris, and it was still, as you see in this photo, as of this morning. We do request you declare it a nuisance. Santa Claus.
Well, they say a picture.
Yeah, and a Christmas tree of tires.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
With a star on top.
And I always, is it Alex? Is that, yeah. Do you understand what's going on here right now, Alex?
Yes.
Yeah. It's just amazing. And I always, when I see things like this, I'm sure you guys feel the same way. I can't imagine the neighbors and how just disrespectful it is to the neighbors, to everybody around, because you just feel compelled that you have this right to do what you see in this picture right here. It's just unbelievable.
And we've been averaging probably 1 to 2 phone calls a day for the last 2 weeks on this property.
On this property.
Yeah. Alone.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay. And they're frustrated with our process, but our process is unfortunately timely. When we discuss it with them, they understand it and calm down. But again, they have to
put up with it in the meantime.
That takes a lot to calm down about.
It does. Yeah.
Well, I will move to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
I second the motion to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
All those in favor of the motion to dispense with the second reading?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Mr. Luby, please call the roll.
Mrs. Seavey?
Yes.
Mr. Davis?
Yes.
Mrs. Sturts?
Yes.
Resolution passes.
Resolution 2019-147, resolution declaring nuisance for accumulated debris at 5498 Delhi Pike, declaring an emergency and dispensing with a second reading.
I introduce and move the adoption of this resolution.
I second the adoption of this resolution.
Any discussion on this resolution?
Yeah, this is the rear property at the rear of the property at 5498 Delhi Pike. It was in the same condition as you see in the picture, so we do request you declare it a nuisance.
I move to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
I second the motion to dispense with the second reading of this resolution.
All those in favor of the motion to dispense with the second reading?
Yes.
Yes. Mr. Luby, please call the roll.
Mrs. Seavey?
Yes.
Mr. Davis?
Yes.
Mrs. Sturts?
Yes.
Resolution passes. We are not in the landscaping business.
Yeah.
We're not in the lawn mowing business. We're not in the debris business. We're not in competition with Remke or Best Way. It's your individual responsibilities to take care of these properties. I'm sorry, but I mean, I read these this time and I thought, do they just wait until they come up as a violator again to get their grass cut? Okay.
Wanted to go back to something Mr. Davis had mentioned earlier and just define that a little bit more for the folks that are listening. You mentioned the properties, the houses that were being taken down, and that program is a land bank program through the Port Authority, the county's Port mm-hmm. Authority. And it's something that you apply for, and they are properties that are delinquent on their taxes. There's a few different things. So basically they measure them to be just
abandoned.
Yeah, basically they should be dealt with. And they have to be in that state for the land bank to take process and do it. There's one house, Greg can help me with the addresses, but down further on Delhi Pike that got taken down on the north side of Delhi Pike. There's one the excavator's sitting in front of. It's the size of the house. Further up the street, there's another house. There's one or two more that are...
We have one more that's still in the pipeline, which is 3907. There is an interest from a developer to take over that property to, you know, make it into a fruitful use. With the land bank program, one of the worst houses on Lower Delhi Pike or on Delhi Pike is 4011, which has been abandoned. We've seen that one repeatedly here. It's unfortunately tied up in a bank until June of 2020. So the land bank was unable to acquire that one in the process. So we submitted about 12 properties. There's limited funds for the land bank. They are running low on funds. They're hoping to get more funds in the future. This is our first go around with it. A lot of other communities were already in the program. We weren't even in their map. They had to get the map amended by the state of Ohio to even allow us in their program. So it took some time to get us there. But if we can get three down this year, that's a start for us. I mean, I hate to see houses go away and just vacant lots, but some of these have just been dilapidated so far beyond fixing them up. And there's holes in the walls and you can see right through the homes. So those are the ones we're trying to really address right away. So,
and those are the gateways to our business district.
And those are the gateway to our community.
Right. Well, that's it exactly. You see, it is, like I said, and it's not because anyone's living in there. They're unsafe structures. When you see them coming down, it's like finally. And those residents that have been down there that take care of their properties and everything, I can't imagine the sigh of relief that they feel like, wow, there's progress here. This is awesome. And it is, as Trustee Sturt says, the first thing you see is you're coming in Delhi and the last thing you see when you leave, unless you tell your friends to enter in off a bender, come up the back way. But again, it's progress. And
we'll have the option of taking over the properties or letting the land bank continue to manage the properties while they're vacant themselves. And this will be a start, hopefully, by accumulating these vacant lots and these structures that are in these conditions to hopefully attract a developer to start meeting the vision of the Plan the Pike in that area where the vision was townhomes kind of lining Delhi Pike coming up the hill.
Coming up the hill.
So it's going to be a slow process, but it's a process we're at least starting. So.
Right. Well, thank you for your good works on that. All right, I do have public comments this evening. Just a reminder, it's 5 minutes. It's not an interaction, but Dan Brown, you're on.
Hello, thank you.
Hi, Dan.
Hello. I just wanted to extend Trustee Seavey's words about how professional our firefighters and police officers are. We do have the best in the business in Delhi. But I also wanted to bring to everyone's attention the state of Ohio painfully passed a budget recently. And in that budget, they took out the PTSD coverage and workers' comp insurance for the first responders, meaning our police and firefighters, if they don't have a physical injury. And it doesn't get any news coverage, but that means if a firefighter or police officer goes through a traumatic incident with a fatality or a child or something, that they can't get the help that they need to fix their issue because they weren't physically hurt. So I'm kind of just trying to ask everybody to call our state reps. We don't have that power here to change that law, but to call our state reps as the trustees, you guys can contact them probably easier to use our power here to kind of do everything we can for our firefighters and police officers. I think they deserve it. They said they were going to come back and talk about it later, but we all know in codes that's probably not going to happen. So hopefully we can do that, and I hope everyone here is watching and can at least write to our reps and our congressperson to tell them to write the PTSD coverage for workers' comp in the budget, even for people that don't have a physical injury, because that's the key part that they hung up. If they get a physical injury, they can still get help, which is good, but as we all know, they deal with a lot of things where they don't get injured. So that's the big one. So I just urge everyone to write to them, call them, email them, so that they can get all the help they can. And that's all.
Thank you. Okay. Mr. Luby, I have announcement of community events.
Dallas Farm Market is now open through August 31st from 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. at Clearview Lake at 5125 Foley Road. The Dahlia Historical Society program, summer's almost gone. The final chapter of the Bricka family is Monday, September 9th at 7 p.m., and that's at the Dahlia Senior Center. The Dahlia Township Veterans General Membership Meeting is Tuesday, September 10th from 7:30 to 8:30 p.m. It's at the Dahlia Senior Community Center at 647 Neeb Road. Understanding Dementia Care is Wednesday, September 11th. Challenging Behaviors in Dementia Care will be from 1 p.m. to 4 p.m. Creative and Practical Tips for Getting Through the Day will be from 7 p.m. to 8:30 p.m. at Mount St. Joe University at 5701 Dahlia Pike. The Concert in Dahlia Park featuring Excalibur will be Friday, September 13th from 7 to 10 p.m. be at the Bicentennial Stage at Dahlia Park. Drive for Your Community fundraiser to benefit the Dahlia Skirt Game, Kids, Cops, and Firefighters event will be Saturday, September 14th from 9:30 to 3:30 p.m. and that's at Shiloh United Methodist Church at 5261 Foley Road. The Clue and Cocktails will be Friday, September 20th from 7:30 to 8:30 p.m. at the Dahlia Park Lodge at 5125 Foley Road. Fire Department Open House will be Sunday, October 13th from 1 p.m. to 4 p.m. and that's at the Fire Headquarters at 697 Neeb Road. The second annual Harvest Hootenanny will be Saturday, October 19th from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. and that will be at Storywoods Park at 694 Pontius Road. That's all we have.
Thank you, Mr. Luby. Just a few reminders, everyone. All of the children in Dahlia Township are back in school, so watch the school zones, watch your speed, and take care of our school children. Secondly, it's Labor Day weekend. Enjoy the family picnic and the good times, but be safe. And at last, our next meeting will be September the 19th, which is a Thursday at 5. So all of you need to change your calendars. It's Thursday, September 19th at 5 o'clock, and we look forward to seeing all of you then. If I could have a motion for adjournment.
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor?
Yes.
Meeting adjourned.